The deadly Ebola virus is now in this country, but our state has some extraordinary laws in place to protect the public if any infectious disease finds its way here. Chris Ingalls explains.
This afternoon, crews sealed in protective clothing began what public health officials admit is the overdue cleanup of the apartment where an Ebola patient lived in Dallas. Four relatives of Thomas Duncan were inside, quarantined. In a phone interview, one of them identified as Oliver said sheriff's deputies required them to sign paperwork.
I'm worried. We were told to sign a paper that we can't leave the apartment.
Relatives expressed frustration that they're imprisoned for up to 21 days. It's a dicey legal question, and to prepare for such an emergency here in Washington, the Attorney General's office drafted this memo 6 years ago. It reinforces the absolute power of county health departments to isolate and quarantine even entire neighborhoods in a public health emergency.
And one advantage of the local health departments having that authority is that they're in the community and they know their community best.
A punishment of up to 90 days imprisonment in county jail is written into law for anyone violating the orders of public health officers. In West Africa, the headlines are grim. More than 3,400 Ebola patients dead so far. But Washington State's health officer says there's no reason for undue concern here.
I'd like to reassure people that we have hospitals that have very good infection control practices, and we have a public health system that's watching out for new and dangerous diseases.
And there are protections in place to keep those diseases from getting here in the first place. SeaTac Airport is one of only 20 in the nation with this special quarantine area and a system to monitor and isolate infectious passengers before they venture onto U.S. soil. Chris Ingalls, Crem 2 News.